This is the place we're staying at in Koh Samui. So you're going down here. Got the bathroom, which is here. There's a shower there, a toilet there, two sinks, a bath, and then there's this view from here, right? A bath with a view. If it focuses, but there's the ocean, there's the sea. I don't know how this works. I don't actually know how it works. I don't know what I've just done to it. Oh, there we go. And then you can have a shower with the view open, which I will probably be doing. Storage, bathrobes, and this is the main area. So you have the bed and a giant mirror and all of this. And then there is a balcony with chairs. And this is the view outside if it decides to focus again. Oh my God. I genuinely think this beats the Siem Reap place. This is literally beautiful. Okay, so hello, we have checked into our hotel in Koh Samui. We're staying at the spot. It's like a villa hotel. Last night, basically, after we ended the island hopping tour, we went and got dinner at the same place we got dinner the other day. And then we went to the beach and got some buckets, then ended up on the beach, and then had some fun on the beach, had some drinks, had a laugh, had some music playing, did that, chill vibes, went in the sea, had an ocean swim, that was all peng. I went to bed at like 2:30 to then wake up for 7. Actually, I didn't go to bed till like 4 because I was watching, no, half three, because I was watching Riverdale. I didn't finish it. Then we had to be up early to get the boat to Krabi and then the bus from Krabi to other place, and then from there another ferry to Koh Samui. Bloody hotel is absolutely stunning. Emma's literally got 100 million videos, but yeah. Also to everyone we met, and if you're watching this, much love. We had such a fab time and we cannot wait to see all of you again. You all know who you are. The 9 people in the end. But yeah, we were chilling, we vibing, and we made such good friends over the last like 48 hours. Good morning, everybody. It is our last day in Koh Samui. I'm going to explain, but I'm going to show you the view quickly because this is a view that we woke up just like 10, 15, 20. Give me a sec. There is the view. There was a massive lizard in the sky. Oh my God, it's nice and warm. The lizard's gone, but this is the view. Look how crystal blue the water is. Wow. Unfortunately, I actually have to update you on something that was decided last night. I'm actually quite upset with it because it's a very big thing that was decided. Give me a sec. The decision last night was taken after seeing tons of messages from family. But I'm in quite a lot of travel groups on Facebook, and a lot of family have been worried about coronavirus and stuff like that. Vietnam has stopped issuing visas for people to come in, and America's closed their borders for people who are from outside the UK. And the situation is progressively getting worse. The time of leaving to come out here, obviously there were the fears, but I kind of just went for it because it transmits not as well in heat. So I was like, okay, let's go for it. But now the threat of borders closing and the mass panic at home and stuff is just making me really unsettled and nervous because I'm quite a home bird, and past few weeks I've been a bit homesick, and the idea of being stuck out here for even longer scares me. Even though there is worse places to be stuck, I'm ready to go home now because I've been home for 6 weeks now. Oh my God, 6 weeks. I'm just ready. And that's my idea of a nightmare, to be honest, to be stuck out here. So I've taken the decision to go home tomorrow. And I'm devastated. Like, as much as I'm happy to go home and I'd rather be at home than out here and then get ill or get stuck out here, I still had Chiang Mai, I still had the elephants, I still had my diving at Koh Tao, we had Koh Phangan, which I wasn't gonna, not really my vibe, but I still wanted to go. And then Bangkok, we had quite a lot to do. So I'm sad. I am very sad because I've been looking forward to it for so many years, like 4 years, 3 years, 4 years. And I'm devastated, to be honest. I'm just kind of in the moment. I'm currently trying to process it, so I'm not really feeling anything. But I know the overwhelming sense is internal sadness. Externally, I'm just kind of like composed and just like, to be fair, it's fine, I can come back, etc., etc. But I'm upset. because it took this long to get out here. But yeah, it's a sad morning. But last night I booked my flights and we're going tomorrow. So we're leaving Koh Samui today to go to Surat Thani tomorrow evening, tonight. And then tomorrow morning we'll fly from Surat Thani to Bangkok. And then in the evening I've got Bangkok back home. So I'm gonna go home, wait for all of this to be done with, let it run its course. And then when it's safe to travel again, or be out here, then I guess it'll be time to come back. And I always know that's gonna be here, so I can come back to it. But it's just the whole, it took this long to get here, and I'm not doing it now. It's kind of like, ugh. But I will be back, and I will come and finish it off. So the vlogs will have a bit of an abrupt ending. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna kind of leave it on this note, leave it on the leaving early. And then when I go back, I'll continue it. I'll finish the series. So it will be finished, hopefully this year, if I get to go, if it works out, or early next year. So I'm really sorry on behalf of myself, because I was really, really excited to make some content, especially with the diving, and especially diving, because I'm scared of water, and I've done so many things this trip that have really tested me. And one of them was snorkeling. I did that one in the ocean, etc., etc. And I'm super proud of myself. And diving was one of the biggest things I wanted to do. And now it's another delayed event. And I'm just like, oh, when it was finally time, I was finally ready. But I mean, I'm still ready and I'm still going to do it. I don't think coming back will be the same, because like Bangkok, we had Nikki as well. And the whole vibe and that. It's just sad. I'm just upset. A bit nostalgic looking back at it now, because it's been, now I've realised that it's the end. It just sucks that I have to end it now and move over my stuff I wanted to do for a next time trip. But I guess it's even more reason to come back. I've not been worried about this virus. Initially Emma was really panicking a lot, like she mentioned it every single day, etc, etc. And I was just kind of avoided because I didn't want to hear about it. And then it got to a point where I'd occasionally update myself, read about it, whatever, and okay, and then I was just like, okay, right, I know this, I know that, then I'll stop. Just recently, it's been very heavy news-wise everywhere. My Twitter is literally full of coronavirus tweets. Every tweet, I think there was 22 in a row that was coronavirus-related. So it kind of does send you into a panic. I'm not worried about the virus. I'm more worried about being stuck, or getting it and give it to someone who can actually die from it. So I will be self-isolating most probably, even if I don't feel ill. We'll see how things go. Because the Gov.UK website says I don't need to, so we'll go from that. But there are worse ways you can spend your morning, your last morning. Yeah. This is the end of 5 weeks. Bye, view.
Because I actually will cry.
Do it, I dare you.
I can't do it on demand, but I will later. Great. I'll send it to you.
And I'll put it in the vlog. Bye. Hello everybody, an update. I'm now at my hotel in Surat Thani. I'm staying at this not Airbnb, but this hotel that's run by a family, and they're really super, they're super sweet. I just went and had dinner, I had some chips and some fried rice. I'm now in my room, and it's basically just like this, and there's a bathroom, whatever. It's super clean, super nice, and it was like a tenner, so. And there's a free transfer to the airport and free breakfast, so. You can't complain. I've kind of had time to think about everything, and I'm not processing it obviously, because I'm kind of still really upset, because at dinner time I was thinking, oh my god, I'm going back to Bangkok tomorrow, and I didn't even do Bangkok fully, and I'm going home. And that just makes me so upset. Emma did a post, she made me a bit upset, to be honest with you. I had one of the best times of my life. And of course, I've said I'm gonna finish it. So this is not the end. This is not the end of the Thai. I'm gonna try and go as soon as possible to finish off what I need to finish when this whole situation blows over, when it's safer to travel and I'm not worrying about it. Because I'm not enjoying it if I'm worrying about it. And that's my whole situation, predicament currently. If I keep thinking about it, I'm gonna worry and not think about the time I'm here and like enjoying myself, etc. etc. If that makes sense. My God, I have learnt a ton and a half about myself. And I said to Emma earlier, the two biggest things I've learned about myself is the fact that I'm attractive. And my colour, as much as people have told me that it's not allowed, people think I look good, people think I'm nice, people think I deserve to be looked after, I deserve to have someone, I deserve to have friends, I deserve to feel love, I deserve to have friendships, people care about me, people want to support me, etc, etc. And people will know that I've struggled with that a lot. Like, people tell me that I love you, and I'm like, do you, or are you just saying that? Because from a young age, I've always been told that my kind, or people like me, or just anything like that, don't deserve what everyone else has because of the way I am, because I'm different. And obviously, because at school, it's not the exact same. It's like a weaker form of it, but it grows with you. And then the whole gay community thing is a whole different thing, which elaborates on top of it. And when you're constantly fed this narrative that you're not good enough, you believe it. And even when people try and tell you that they care about you, they love you, they appreciate, they want you around, you will not believe it. And everyone in uni, this is my example, everyone in uni knows exactly what I'm on about. And if you're listening to this and you know what I'm on about, this is for you, basically. I've come on this trip with all that at home. I've come here with that in my head. But I've learned through new experiences and meeting new people that, hang on, these people find me really funny, these new people, and they've known me for what, 5 minutes? They think I'm really funny, I'm really kind, I'm really sweet, I'm generous, I'm friendly. And then when they get to know me, they're like, you're really lovely. Like, when you have deeper conversations, which I love, having deeper conversations is like the best conversation when you meet new people. We always talk about deeper issues, and this always crops up because it's something that I really, really, really hate about myself. And a lot of people have picked up on the fact that I'm very oversensitive, and I've addressed that. I am, and I know I am. But being here, people have been like, oh my God, you're such a lovely person, you're so attractive, like, you look really nice, etc, etc. After knowing me for what, like 10 minutes, they're like, oh my God, I love you, like, you deserve to be happy, etc, etc. And I'm like, do you know what, if someone who I've known for 5 minutes is telling me this, then it's gotta mean something for the people back home. And I've slowly started, I think I'm okay with it, I'm accepting it, and I'm taking it, and I'm now believing it and allowing myself to receive the things that are being said about me and not doubting it, because my head is now slowly starting to change its mindset. I'm starting to change my mindset on it and looking at it like, no, Rochelle, these are new people. This is a whole new situation. This isn't you being a kid anymore. These people do want you around. These people do actually want you to be here. And that's one of the biggest things I've learned. And the second thing I've done is taking my t-shirt off and swimming in the ocean, snorkeling, scuba diving nearly, which we will do, we'll come back to. But I'm so damn proud of myself. And I've lost like 3.4 kg. So I'm even more like over the moon with that, because that's something that I wanted to achieve, especially because I'm back. And I did it, and I'm happy, and I'm feeling a bit more body confident. Granted, I'm not 100%, I'm probably 2% out of 100, but that's something. And I'm proud of myself, I genuinely am. Yeah, that's something I really wanted to grow and develop with, and I've been able to start doing that. So hopefully we've got the wheels turning and we can carry it on. It's been hard. There's been instances where I've just put my glasses on and just started crying because I've been so embarrassed to be around so many people, like on the beach. Like, it's hard. It is hard for me, and it still is. But I'm making strides and I'm making steps forward. And good job, Rochelle. When you're editing this, it won't probably sink in until a bit later, like how big of a thing this is for you. But body shaming and body confidence is something that I've been bothered with since I was like, what, 9? And even my friends, Anna, I will not take my t-shirt off in front of Anna. She has to force me to do it, and Anna's one of my closest friends. And that tells you so much. I won't even do it in front of my parents. That tells you something, doesn't it? That's how much I hate myself. But we've done it. We've started to do it. And yeah, Rochelle editing. I hope you realize how big of an accomplishment this is for you. I realize it is past Rochelle when you're looking back at this, because it really will show you how much you have done. Yeah, my flight tomorrow is from Bangkok to London with Etihad at like 8:05 p.m. However, I'm flying from here to Bangkok in the morning, and then I have like 8 hours at the airport to chill. So I might buy treat myself to a lounge pass to cut some hours out. So I'll see you in the morning. Okay, so I've arrived in Bangkok. I'm at the small airport in Bangkok. My flight there is from the other airport in Bangkok. If you can hear me, I was meant for my next flight is in like 10 hours. I'm gonna get an airport lounge later when I'm able to check in, so I'm at 5. Currently, and my plan was to go to the other airport, drop my bag off, and then go out into the center to do a temple I wanted to do and sit in the park and have lunch. However, this is the current weather situation. And this bus takes 2 hours to get there. 1 hour 50 minutes, I think. And it's free, so that's brilliant. So if you just go from the DMK airport to the BKK one, or vice versa, I'm pretty sure it's free. So that's my plans on the window. So I don't know what I'm going to do for the next like 10 hours. I'm probably trying to edit my videos. Try and start chopping things up and like fixing things and like, figuring out what I want to do. I want to get some Dior Sauvage today. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to approach chillity and then like edit some videos, do some reading and things like that. But I'm in Bangkok and it's a dreary morning. Hello everyone, so I'm in a lounge. I'm in a first class lounge and I only paid 20 quid for it. I'm just going to give you a quick tour. I'm super buzzing because I'm going to stuff my face. This is the Miracle Lounge at Bangkok Airport, the main airport. And I'm literally sitting down here. I'll show you around. There's a bar which I'm going to drink at. There's a whole dining room at the bottom, the showers. There's this, oh my god, might have a glass of that. And there's a nice and like, well look at all this, I'm gonna stab them off everything. There's like a proper dining room, like dining room, internet room, like toilets and things down there. And just like stuff like that down there. I'll show you after there, after I've like eaten some food down there. But that's the update. So love, this is like the starters. I've got a soda water and got some coffee liqueur, brownies, some watermelon, this Fanta, this bottle of water, 2 sandwiches, this blueberry Danish, this banana chocolate muffin, this orange cheesecake, and that's just the beginning. I'm gonna go to the dining room and get some more food, and I'm literally gonna stuff my face. Okay, so I literally have like 20 minutes until my gate opens. I'm just gonna look at some books. I wanna see if I can find any books I want to buy. I'm gonna have a shower just because I can, and I wanna freshen up before the flight because I feel groggy and I've been away since like 6. So let's do a quick shower tour. Literally just this massive ass shower. There. Come on, focus then. Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna change it out of this into something nicer. But proper nice look. All these amenities. Gonna use that. Not gonna use that. Where's that toothbrush? Might take that with me. Conditioner, that's cute. And the towel. So that's paying. So I shall see you on the shower side. And we are ready to go. So, we're gonna get this right. After 3 flights, totaling of 16 hours and 12 hour gaps in between, 1 hour tube and 1 hour train, I am finally back in the UK, back at my home, and the quarantining begins. I'm feeling fine. However, we're gonna be safe. We're gonna not spread it to anyone else. So I'm staying in, not really gonna socialize with anyone. If I start to feel ill, then I'll quarantine. So right now I'm like moving and mooching around my house. However, the moment I start to feel ill, I'm locking myself in my room. It's been a hectic travel hours. I'm trying not to sleep until later so then I can restore my cycles to normal balance. Yeah, an abrupt end. We didn't anticipate coronavirus, so damn you. This isn't over. Let's just call this a blip. Let's call this a break, and we shall continue when we go back. But I really do hope you've enjoyed everything you've seen so far. I've put a lot of time and effort into editing all the videos and doing the best I can. If you have, please leave a like, and don't forget to subscribe my Instagram and my 21 button. There's a link down below. And yeah, I shall see you guys in whatever video comes up next, because this will probably be the last one that comes out. So that's like, what, in like 3 months? So this quarantining thing is gonna be good for me to actually start editing. The book isn't finished. I hope you've enjoyed it so far. You stick along for the end. So I shall see you as soon as I can. Bye for now.